So welcome to this presentation, and we're going to have a look at installing the newly released OpenSUSE 11.4. So I've just booted up from the DVD and chosen the installation. I've just set my screen size to 800 by 600, so it's easier to fit in for the Camtasia Studio. The first thing, as always, we're going to be asked to select our language, so we'll choose the language UK, which also sets my keyboard layout. We can accept the license agreement, detecting the hardware, here we can say it's a new installation rather than trying to update, and I'm just going to turn off the auto configuration so we'll see all of the questions. You can see the time zone's already been set because I chose United Kingdom as my language, so the system assumes then that I will be installing into the UK. OpenSUSE for a while has defaulted to the KDE desktop, and I'm just going to use the GNOME desktop. Just different graphical environments. I'm more used to GNOME, having worked with that more than KDE. Setting up the partitioning. I've got one disk and it's been partitioned up to have a swap partition of 1.5 times the memory, the root file system, and then a home file system. And they've both been formatted with ext4. We can have a look to see how it's been set up. On the configure button, we can set up iSCSI or multipath. We can import other disks. We can go through and edit. So here I'm just editing the home partition. You can see it's formatting with ext4, but we've got things like the butterfs, which is now included as standard. We won't make any changes here. I'm going to leave this at the default, but this is really so you can plan how your disks will be set up and what space you reserve for different parts of your file system. We have to have at least one user. So if we set up a user called Geeko and his password, and by default, this is also going to be the password of the system administrator. It doesn't have to be. If I unselect that, it's going to ask me then for the root password. The system administrator is root. And I'm just turning off the root login. Not the root login, sorry, the automatic login. It prompted me about a too simple password, but that's okay on the test system. So it gives me a summary of what it's going to do. If we go through and look into booting, we can see that we're still using the grub bootloader, and these are going to be the options in the menu. If we move on to the bootloader installation tab, we can see that we can choose between grub and Lilo. Lilo is the Linux loader, it's much earlier. And we're going to be installing this into the root partition, but we could also install into the MBR. And we can see that we're going to boot from dev SDA. As we jump down, looking at what it's going to install, we can see the software. And there's been some changes here. So if I open up the software, obviously, as you were seeing, as the software progresses within the open source market, then so is it going to change in distributions like OpenSUSE. So we can see what's available through our patterns. So this just gives me a rough idea of what I can install. But if I go through, say, to search, and now I'm going to search for Libre, and you see, instead of having OpenOffice, we now have LibreOffice, the fork from the OpenOffice developers. So we just leave that at the default. We won't add anything else in at this stage. This just shows me any of the additional software that's going to need to be selected. Moving down from software, We see right at the bottom, we've got the firewall. So I'm just going to disable the firewall. I would normally do this on my systems unless I particularly needed the firewall enabled. I like this, the installation is warming up. Set the host name now, so we've gone through and done the installation. We're in the second phase, so the installation would take, say, 10-15 minutes to install those files. I've just cut those out of the video. I'm not going to change the host name via DHCP, and I don't need to say assign it to the local interface. So I'm just setting a host name of SUSE 11-4. Obviously, the host name becomes your choice. I'm not using DNS or anything like that here. We see the network configuration. So we see at the top the general network settings. It's using the standard IFUP control. So when the system boots up, it sets its IP address rather than having it done on user logins. VNC we could enable so we could manage the machine remotely. I won't test my connection to the internet, but it will try and connect anyway to set up the internet repositories. The repositories are just installation sources that on the network that I could install additional software from. So rather than having to distribute everything on the CD, there are public repositories or software sources that I can install from. We'll add the standard ones in, but there might be other repositories that I can add in. I'm not going to update my system. It'd be interesting to see. It's only been out a day. I wonder if there are any updates, but for the moment, I'll skip the updates. The online updates will run regularly anyway. The release notes might be worth reading. We can always read these from the etc directory later, but it just gives you an idea of some of the new things that are in this release, so OpenSUSE 11.4, and then how it might have changed from the previous release, 11.3. So now we'll go through and try to detect printers. I don't have any printers connected to the system, and I don't have any cup servers advertising on the network, so it won't detect any. But then we've got the sound, and I don't have any TV card. So that's it, we've done. I could create an answer file based on this installation with clone for AutoYes, but I won't. So now the system comes out of the run level for the installation and then goes to its default run level 5, which is the full graphical environment. So we can see some of the new graphics here for OpenSUSE 11.4. So some funky chameleons. So I can then log in as my Geeko user. Once we've done that, we're obviously presented with my GNOME desktop that I selected. And we'll be able to see some of the new features. Obviously, we won't look at everything at the moment, but we'll fire up LibreOffice and then we'll look at Firefox. You'll see that we've got Firefox 4 and then LibreOffice on the system. One of the nice things in LibreOffice is that we can integrate directly with Google Docs. So if that's what you like using, then LibreOffice has some nice features for that. So we'll just fire up the writer products of the word processor. And then we can see from the file menu, we can then go to Google Docs. So we can then import or export to Google Docs or other web dev providers. When we're looking at saving as, you can see it supports a range of document formats, including the DocX formats of the latest version of Microsoft Office. And have a quick look at Firefox. So Firefox 4, I think, have just gone into a release candidate, but we've got a beta version, so you can see we're using beta 12. So this hopefully gives you an idea of some of the new features of OpenSUSE, and maybe some ideas to get you involved in the SUSE project or starting using Linux. But thank you today for your time. We'll look forward to seeing you back soon.